A crazy little thing called love. Give yourself a round of applause!
Hey! Right, I'll tell you what.
Hang on.
This is a bit slippy, this floor. Who was that? Who came to me help? Who was it?
There was a little bit of concern over this way, but not a great deal, Lee, I'm not gonna lie.
She's my hero! Have you seen me knee, by the way? Look what I've done.
Oh, here we go. He hasn't just done that now. Don't feel... Ladies and gentlemen, I feel we owe you a bit of an explanation. Lee and I
are not waiters here. Terrible ones. We'd have been fired.
We are, in fact, from the Silver Service Singers, Secret City Waiters! Now listen, hiya. We didn't just drive by this beautiful venue and think, yeah, that looks nice, we'll go sing in there this aft.
I did.
Did you?
Yeah.
I got booked. Oh. Somebody invited me here, and by the looks on a few of your faces, you didn't know we were coming, did you?
who did know we were coming?
Put your hands on.
One, two, three. So like the whole top table.
Oh, I'm about the staff, that don't count. Who didn't know that we were coming? Put your hands on. Oh, it's a bit of a surprise. It is a surprise from your bride and groom. Give it up! Now, Emma phoned us. She said, Alex Lee, will you come and sing for my friends and family because they are absolutely crackers. Is that right?
Yeah.
Come on. It's a party now. Is that right?
Yeah.
Right then, we're going to test the waters. We've had a little warm-up. We're going to have another song for a warm-up. So you've had to sit down. Everybody, get up off your seats and let's party. Come on now.
If you see a fading sign on the side of the road,
it's
15 miles to the...
Oh, come on! Try it again. Clap your hands, it's dead.
Yeah. Love Shack, yeah.
Emma.
She's heading down the Atlanta Highway.
Look at the moves on him.
Looking for the lights go the way.
No.
The Love Shack, baby.
Love Shack, baby. Love Shack, baby. Love Shack, baby. Love Shack,
baby. Love Shack, baby. Love Shack, baby. Oh, baby, that's where it's at.
Oh, nice.
Love, baby, that's where it's at.
Listen. Sign says, stay away, fools. The club rules at the Love Shack.
We'll sit way back in the middle of the bit. Just a fucking old shack.
This table, we have some warming up to do.
We're gonna break it down.
Are you ready? We're gonna do the bang, bang, bang. You know it.
Do it.
No. Right, we're gonna break it down. Everyone's gonna do the bang, bang, bang. Are you ready? They're not ready over there. This table are a bit cracked. You're gonna get a bit better. You're alright. You're not.
Say it how it is. They're alright.
Here we go.
Alright, break it out.
Here's a little old place where we can get together. The Love Shack, baby.
The Love Shack, baby.
Love Shack, baby. Love Shack. Love Shack, baby. Love Shack.
Everybody.
You got to know the words for this, me, don't you?
Come on, Mr. Beats!
Come on, Beatley! You ready, boy? One, two, three, go! Come on, man!
On the ball, man!
You missed it, woman.
Keep loving. Love Shack, baby, Love Shack.
Behave yourself. Get here.
Baby, Love Shack.
Hugging and a kissing, dancing and a loving.
At the Love Shack. Give a round of applause. He tried, didn't he? They tried over there.
We need to know. They had a go. They were setting him up, so what's his name?
Healing.
Nearly, yeah, his name is Nearly. He nearly had a go. Right, listen.
He was setting you right up there, wasn't he? Oh, he tried, though. Are you in with anyone, Nearly? Your wife.
Oh.
Is his rhythm that bad throughout his life? He was like a cat in a bag.
Right, listen, we've had enough of our Daily and you guys, but I think it's time we draw our attention to two very important people. Do you? Shall we draw our attention?
I agree.
I think Nick should bring his lovely wife out to the dance
floor
space.
Ladies and gentlemen, please raise the roof.
Look at that over there. Look at all that
space. Yeah, look at this room.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for your bride and groom.
Give it up!
Come on, this way. Nick, this way, over here. Come on, all this space.
I did not know this before.
Now listen, it's not you I really want to have a word with at the moment, it's this young man. I'll take that back. Listen, Lee and I have the pleasure of going around the country performing at weddings, and I know from surveying the gentlemen, there's something playing on your mind. We've got the ceremony out of the way, the speeches, don't even need to worry about them. I'm talking about a little bit later on tonight, if you know what I'm talking about.
There's a lot of pressure to perform.
No.
Just on the groove.
No. Get your mind out of the gutter, please. I'm talking about the first dancers, husband and wife. We've hatched a plan to make it a little bit easier on you for later on.
Here we are.
And that plan is to have a practice right now. What do you reckon? Brilliant. There's no pressure.
No pressure.
It's the unofficial first dance. No pressure.
Practice, rehearsal, unofficial, not a real first dance.
Would not make a scene.
Oh, they've got to look at you. They're going to take your photo. Well, this is not the real one. All this will do, it'll go on that selfie telly later on. So, ladies and gentlemen, while they embrace unofficially.
There you go.
Please give a nice, warm, unofficial welcome to the new Mr. and Mrs. Evers. Let's hear it. And don't worry, you've been joining halfway through this. Just give them a bit of time.
Birds flying high. You know how I feel.
Take this seriously, please.
Sorry.
Sun in the sky. You know how I feel. Breeze just drifting on by. You know how I feel. Well, it's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new life for me. Grab the one that you love, folks, and come and join them after you've sung with us. Ready? And I'm feeling good.
Give it all for Mr. and Mrs. Evans, come on! Let's go! Oh.
Right, come on, join them on the dance floor. Bring your love to them. Get down, get down.
That's the way.
Get down there. Good man. Off you go.
Fish in the sea, you know how I feel.
This is lovely.
River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on a tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life,
oh,
for me.
Everybody!
And I'm feeling good.
Oh yeah!
Like a fly out in the sun, you know how I mean. Butterflies are having fun, you know how I mean. Sleeping in peace is the world. And the solar world is a new world. You know how I feel. Set to the pine, you know how I feel. Oh, freedom isn't mine. I know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life.
Oh, I feel, you know, I feel the love in this room so much.
We should do another spoochy spoochy, shouldn't we?
Because these people didn't have a chance to dance. Mr. and Mrs. Evans, everybody, can I hear it? Can I hear it? And for the people that didn't get the chance to have a smoochy smoochy, we've got you back. We've got you back. Everybody,
keep going. Keep going.
Everybody that's in love, get out of your seats. Come on now.
I got sunshine.
Let's go.
Let's hear you sing. Well, I guess you say, what can make me feel this way?
You go.
My girl, talking about my girl. I got so much honey, the bees and me.
I'm back.
Got a sweetest song, baby, and the birds in the trees.
Join it. Here we go.
I guess you say, what can make me feel?
Raise all together.
Come on.
My girl. I'm talking about my girl.
My girl.
Ooh.
the one that you love isn't here, grab your husband or your wife. Let's go! All together now.
Here we go.
One more time, you love. Give a round of applause to all those dancers out there, all the dancers.
Lovely stuff.
That was the love section. But I've got something on my mind, Lee.
Oh, what's that? What's that?
I think I need our Emma and our... I feel like Nick. I've jumped over the friendship barrier. Call him Nick. Should I call you Nicholas? Nick. Nice.
You call one. Him whatever you like, as long as you call him.
Right, listen. There's something... Simon. Simon? Gonna call you Simon or something? Now listen, the only two people we knew were going to be here today was you two. Yep. I want to just ask about the rest of these people, a lot of people here. Have they come with you? Have they come with you? Is it more of your friends? Are they having a little bit of a contest? When it gets down to it, I want to know who's the more popular out of these two. Right? Who do you think?
Emma.
Let's just have a little test, but I've got some, a little game in my mind. Is it Nick?
Oh, awkward. You just paid for it, mate. That's fine. You just paid for it.
Thanks, see
you,
mate. Or is it Emma? We're going to give you a chance to get back in this game. All right,
to be honest, I'm not a gambling man, but I think you know which way it's going.
I've got a game that's going to be impartial, and it also gets the people at the seats that have been sat down. You've got no chance of staying in your seats. Ladies and gentlemen, in a few seconds' time, two trains will be leaving this station.
This is really awkward, isn't it?
They're going to come around the room, they're going to tap you on the shoulder, and they're going to ask you to join the back of their train. I think you know where this is going. It's longest train at the end of this song wins. Train drivers, Emma and Nick, if you're ready, can I get a... People that have been sat down, you're not going to be sat down. Nick, Emma, go get yourself some passengers! Here we go! Love this train wins! Let's go!
Get in, get in! When I wake up,
well
I know I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you. And when I go out, well I know I'm gonna be the man who's go along with you. And when I get drunk, well I know I'm gonna be the man who gets drunk next to you. And when I hear my,
what does that mean?
Well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's sleeping to you.
Everybody sing it!
When I would walk 500 miles, when I would walk 500
miles,
just to be the man who walks 1,000 miles, to fall down a shot on the ground. When I'm working, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's working hard for you. And when the money comes in for the work I do, I'll pass almost everything you want to do. When I go out, well I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. And when I go, well I know I'm gonna be. And listen, you're just going around in circles here. But I would walk 500 miles and I would walk 500 more. To be the man who walks 1,000 miles to fall.
Everybody sing!
Better.
All right, boat race at the minute.
Well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's lonely without you. And when I'm dreaming, well, I know I'm gonna dream about the times when I'm with you. When I go, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. And when I come home,
when I come home,
well, I know I'm gonna be the man. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I'm gonna be the man who's coming home.
It's a bit close. Everybody sing,
ready? 1, 2, 3.
Well, I will walk 500 miles and I will walk 500 more to be the man who walks 1,000 miles to fall out. Blaze the roof.
This is evidence. Well, hang on. Where's Nick? Go on. Yeah. Hang on. Oh.
I can't tell where one train ends and the other begins here.
That's because, are you ready for this? I'll practice this one. Alex, that's because it's two families journey.
Oh, shut up. I'm not having that. Listen, we're going to have to call that a draw, ladies and gentlemen. But wait, no. Oh. I'm not having it.
Oh.
Nick, Emma. Down to the table, please. I'm not having that. We're having a competition. I'm not having it as a draw.
No.
Why?
No, we can't have it.
We're not having a draw.
It is quite nicely split here. I'm going to get hold of Nick before I tell him the next idea. We are going to settle this
once and for all
with a sing-off. Listen to all the cutlery drop there. Well, listen.
That got three people excited.
We're not here to embarrass these two. So we're going to get you guys to choose a side. Now, obviously, it's your day. You're here for the ride.
You're just here.
So, are you two friends? Are you right? You're on that team, you're on that team. Right. Split the room.
They have to think about it, though. They're like, yeah,
she's all right.
I guess.
Emma, which side of the room would you like to represent you in this thing?
This one.
And by default,
Team
Nick makes some noise!
She's just turning back on her own family.
Hang on a minute, is that all your family in that side?
Yeah.
This is a bit awkward. Now this, I believe this is a very special song. It's a Smoochie Smoochie Take That song. What's some Take That fans in the room?
Yeah.
Four of you, brilliant.
Brilliant.
You, in the chorus, you know what the words are, so collectively, you're going to have to raise the roof and sing for your respective team captains. So, Team Emma, make some noise! Team Nick, make some noise! And let's sing this classic.
The skies up above me.
Hey Emma, they're doing you proud.
Take it away with them.
The stars.
Everybody, don't close your eyes.
Don't fade away.
Go for it.
See you later.
Can you and me, we can light up the stars. If you stay, then we can.
On this side.
All the stars are coming out tonight. They're lighting up the sky tonight. For you.
All together.
For you.
All the stars are coming out tonight. They're lighting up the sky tonight.
For you.
Everybody at once.
For you.
Come on, Emma. Come on, Nick.
For the chorus.
For you. All the stars are coming out tonight. If you stay with me, girl, we will rule the world.
Yeah, you and me, we can light up the sky. If you stay by my side,
we can rule the world.
All together.
Draw. All I heard you say was assholes. So
I think assholes. No. Listen, in the interest of carrying on, I'm gonna call it a draw, but I've got another idea to settle this. Another idea. Let me get out of him, I'm gonna get out of him again.
And he's never gonna milk it.
This one's a parole with a dance off.
Even worse than sing.
Oh, that funny. But listen, like I said, we're not here to embarrass you two, so I want to start with the fellas and Nick, and I want you to give me the name of four lads that have stitched you up well and truly, proper done you over for whatever reason. Four lads.
Chris Evans.
Chris Evans!
Don't laugh, Neil, you're next.
Oh, hey!
Deal,
come on, Best
man can't get away with it.
Come on, Danny,
let's... Get in, get out. Best over in Rotherham, Sam Oxley.
Go on, Sam Oxley!
Easy.
All four here.
Four lads down here.
Hello, Tiger.
I tell you what, no, Nick, four's a bit of a funny number. You might as well stand in the middle of there as well.
You must look like a boy band now with five of them.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is Leigh and I's great pleasure to introduce to you Chesterfield and surrounding boroughs. Brand new boyfriend.
A boy band.
Boyfriend.
Brand new boyfriend.
Brand new boyfriend.
You just got that.
Ladies and gentlemen, raise the roof, please, for Wrong Direction!
Go on, lads.
Go on, lads.
Now, Wrong Direction are just about to embark on a countywide tour of the pubs and clubs, and they're not quite ready. This is where our Emma comes in.
Emma!
We need the name of your mental friend in here, the first on the dance floor and the last off the dance floor. What is her name?
Kimberly!
Kimberly. Yes, Kimberly! Round of applause for Kimberly! Oh, Kimberly.
Hiya.
Kimberly, you're over here. Back it up, Mr. Cameraman. Because Kimberly, you've got a very important job, my love. Come over here. You
a Wrong Directions brand new choreographer. She's the Sunita of Chesterfield. So now, we know that Emma would not just throw your name into the mix willy-nilly. She thinks you're the best in the biz. So we are going to entrust our absolute faith in you. So, whatever dance moves you do, they're going to do. You take whatever you want off.
Do you want to sit down? Do you want to sit down? So, boys, if Kimberly winds her hips, you all have to wind your hips.
If Kimberly takes her shoes up, no, we didn't need your shoes up. If Kimberly, can you do the splits, Kimberly?
Not in this.
What did I say? Never mind.
You copy whatever she does. Now, Kimberly, are you ready?
No.
No, excuse me. Wrong direction.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen of the audience, are you ready? Yeah.
Take it away.
Go, Kimberly.
Oh, Kimberly, they're all yours.
Come on, Kimberly.
And everybody in the audience, give them some encouragement. Clap along. Sing along.
Is dancing, that's no lie. We spent the night in this town at every kind of disco. From the night I was just a young man on sunshine, young man on the moonlight, young man on the good times,
laying on the boogie.
Young man on the sunshine, young man on the moonlight.
Oh boy!
You just can't take your eyes off me.
Everybody!
Don't blame on sunshine. Don't blame on the moonlight. Don't blame on the good times. Blame on the boogie. Don't blame on sunshine. Don't blame on the moonlight.
Oh, I like it.
Don't blame on the good times. Blame on the boogie.
I'm interrupting here. You're having a minute, right?
My baby's always dancing. Would it be a bad thing? But I don't get no love.
Get your breath, fat boy.
Let's go now. We spent the night in Frisco. And every night in disco. From when I kiss out of goodbye.
1, 2, 3.
Don't bring on sunshine. Don't bring on the moonlight. Don't bring on the good times.
It's a long song, only 6 minutes to go. 6 minutes to go. Clap your hands, everybody. Boogie.
You just got that sunshine. Yeah. Moonlight. Good times.
Just one more chorus, boys. Let's go, give it a
sunshine. Don't play on moonlight. Don't play on good times. Just play on
boogie.
Don't you play on sunshine. Don't play on moonlight. Don't play on good times.
Nearly
there, boys. Sunshine, moonlight, good times. Yeah. Boogie, you didn't get that sunshine. Yeah. Moonlight, good times.
Blame it on the boogie. Give it up for Wrong Direction and Kimberly.
Oh, thank you.
Boys. You will be glad to know you've got a little rest of about 3.5 minutes. But Kimberly, it's now the ladies' turn, so you're pulling a double shift, I'm afraid. dance to. Bonus points for gathering a group that maybe replicate this group, grabbing the microphone off us and singing the tunes to yourself, because the tune I'm on about goes like this.
You ready?
I don't know if you're ready.
I don't know.
One, two, three, four.
It's not played, fine.
Shall I come over and do it while you come over here?
Hang on.
Yeah, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. So tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. So tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I wanna really, really, really wanna sing it, sing it. If you want my future,
forget my past. If you wanna get with me, better make it. Watching those girls shimmying, whining it around, I can't remember what the fellas did.
No, so we'll have to, a bit hypnotised.
We'll have to call it
a draw.
A draw, ladies and gentlemen.
It's a draw.
But I'm not having it.
We never saw that coming.
I'm not having it.
What's that?
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got but one choice before we get on to the main event, which is speeches, which is coming very quickly after this. We've got one more song. We're going to add not only the singing, the dancing, the hooting, the hollering, we're going to add some choreography. Get hold of your nearest napkin, ladies and gents.
Everyone, grab a napkin.
Doesn't matter if it's got a bit of food on it, because it's going to go on the person to your left or your right anyway. And we're going to do a song. In the verses, we're just going to go gentle and easy. Oh, just gently. Have you all got your napkins out there? You lot in the corner, I can see you. That's your way.
Good job, good job.
We have one more song. Nice and easy in the verses and in the choruses, you can just do whatever you want, but don't take anybody's heads off.
At the end of the song, we're going to count to three, and after three, the video man is going to capture every single one of the napkins thrown into the air.
And then catch them again because there's flames on the table.
Yeah, just mind the candles.
Mind the candles,
health and safety.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Lee and myself, we are the Silver Service Singers here on behalf of Mr. and Mrs. Evans. Can I get a round of applause, please? Woo!
Let's take this home, Nick Emmett. Let's take it home in style. Come on. Nice and easy in the verses. Oh. Singing, dancing, all bonus points. Let's go.
Here we go. I woke up today with this feeling. The better things are coming my way. And if the sunshine is a meeting,
doctor's gonna get. Who knows this bit?
For the rainy days are dying, gotta keep on trying. All the reason the birds are flying. Never let go, gotta hold on it. Don't stop till the break of dawn.
Here we go, double speed, here we go.
Get on up, when you're down, baby. Take a good look around. I know it's not much, but it's okay. We'll keep on moving on anyway.
DJ, DJ, gentle, gentle, gentle.
I feel like I could be screaming, trying to get through to my friends.
I got it. You got it.
Like a full meaning. Things will be alright in the end.
You ready?
With a rainy day, I'm
crying.
Get on up when you're down, baby. Take a good look around. I know it's not much, but it's okay. We'll keep on moving on anyway.
Gentle, gentle, gentle.
Solo, solo,
solo.
When the rainy days are dying,
we gotta keep on trying. All the bees and birds are flying. Ah, ah, ah. Never let go, gotta hold on it. Non-stop till the break of dawn.
Get on up,
come together.
Go down, baby. Take a good look around. I know it's not much,
Emma.
But it's okay.
Nick, congratulations, you two. Give a round of applause.
Get on up when you're down, baby. Take a good look around. I know it's not much, but it's okay. We'll keep on moving on anyway. Get on up when you're down, baby. Take a good look around. I know it's not much, but it's okay. We'll keep on moving on anyway.
Come on, let's hear it.
Get on up when you're down, baby. Take a good look around. I know it's not much, but it's okay. Keep on moving on anyway. Get on. When you're down, baby, take a good look around. I know it's not much, but it's okay. Keep on moving on anyway.
1, 2, 3, yeah! One more time. Congratulations, thank you very much, everyone, from Alex, myself, Lee, and Mr. and Mrs. Evans. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time we've all been waiting for, the speeches. Right, the proudest man in the room, Roger.
Follow that.
Nick, give it to him.
Well, here goes. Can everyone hear me?
No, yeah, no.
I'll
try
the mic then. I bet I'm going to use it. Right. Is that better?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. First of all, I'd like to thank you all for joining us to share this special day celebrating the marriage of our daughter Emma to Nicholas Evers.
Can you speak up a bit?
Seeing our daughter looking so beautiful in her wedding dress and walking her down the aisle today has made me so proud to be her father. This day has been brought together through the hard work and creativity of both Emma and her mum, and with a little bit of help from Nick too. I'd like to thank the Van Dyke team for organising the day and providing the beautiful meal we have all just enjoyed. Now, I'm sure it's tradition for the father of the bride to say a few words about his daughter on this special day in her life. So here goes. Get ready, Emma. As a child, Emma was a happy, loving, energetic little girl. She was a joy to be around and have in our lives. I remember lots of happy times playing footy with her in the garden. This is where she probably learned the skills which came in handy when she decided in her late teens to give football a go and joined a local girls' football team. She started swimming lessons at an early age and did so well she gained a 1,000 metre swimming badge at only 5 years old. And we're hoping that Isla follows in her footsteps. When Emma was young, it was the time we were modernising our first house. We did used to spend a great deal of time visiting DIY stores. So much so, every time we used to put Emma's coat on to go out anywhere, she'd say enthusiastically, "Are we going to B&Q, Dad?" When she nags you, Nick, to the DIY, you know where she gets it from. Get ready when you get your new house. Like most children, she used to like watching Disney movies, but her favourite movie was actually the original Wizard of Oz. Emma and her cousin Nicola, because of her hair at the time. Nicola was Dorothy. Emma was Dorothy, and Nicola was the Cowardly Lion. Emma loved it that much, we jokingly asked her if she wanted to change her name to Dorothy. Needless to say, she wasn't too pleased when we told her we were only kidding. At first, Emma wasn't too keen when Matthew was born. This soon changed when she decided to play mum and take him for a walk in her doll's pram. We'll never know how she fitted him in there, but he certainly didn't seem to mind. Emma did very well at school, gaining her GCSEs and A-levels. She then went on to gain a degree in psychology and sociology at Allen University. This is where she met Sarah, who is today one of her lovely bridesmaids. They spent many boozy student nights together and formed a great friendship which they still share today. While studying at university, Emma started a part-time job at Morrison's. She spent time on the checkouts and can be proud her photo made it into the staff handbook as the face at the checkout.
You got it?
No.
We're going to bring you in.
No,
don't
put it on there.
Do not
put it on there.
We're going to blow your tongue. From the checkouts, Emma progressed to the admin office along with her partner in crime, Ella, another one of her lovely bridesmaids today. I remember the time Emma and Ella came on holiday with us to Tenerife. Needless to say, the novelty of free all-day cocktails took its toll within the first couple of hours, as they both ended up worse for wear. Most mornings we'd find their towels thrown on our balcony. No sunbed duties for them that week, too busy nursing hangovers. Now having a taste for an holiday abroad, she didn't hesitate to go to Mallorca to join Ailey, her lovely maid of honour today. On her last week in Mallorca after working there for 6 months. They had an absolute blast travelling round to different beaches and clubbing most nights. And it says here that I've got, thank goodness for beach pipes, really. That's all that sells, that one. Oh, Emma went to work at Capita, dealing with pensions. This is where she met Nick. 3 years ago, she came home on Valentine's Day and said she was going for a drink with someone from work. We of course thought, great, she's finally going on a date. However, she did tell us not to get our hopes up, it was only a drink. Nick must have created a really good impression that night, because from that day, they were inseparable.
You've met him, don't you?
They moved in together and later went on to buy their first house. A year later, they became parents to their beautiful daughter, Isla, and they couldn't have made us feel any more proud than we did that day. We are so impressed at the way you have both embraced parenthood and are a loving family unit. In Nick, Emma's found a level-headed, kind, loving and patient husband and father to Isla.
Are you sure you're talking about it?
I know.
It's a good day.
Joyce?
Cheers, Mum.
You'll never be to Joyce.
I love him, really.
Jason, Colin, you should be very proud of yourself.
I am, love, I am.
We are delighted to welcome Nick to our family, and he has already settled in well. He has a great relationship with his now brother-in-law, Matt. I know he's already used to Liz saying what she thinks. I'm sure he doesn't listen half the time, but neither do I.
Wait till you get back to that room later, Roger.
Somebody better take that. It gives us great pleasure that we entrust our daughter into Nick's care, and we hope this day is the beginning of a wonderful life together as husband and wife. With this, I'd like to propose a toast. Will you please stand and raise your glass to the bride and groom, Emma and Nick.
The next one is from the groom, Nicholas Evers. Nicholas Simon. Thank you. I can remember him out just before I walked up. Evers comes up to me and says, "Piers, how did you pull that?" Well, I tell you now, I get to repay that compliment. Evers, how did you pull that? To the luckiest man in this room, Nicholas Evers.
Thank you, Richard. That's a lovely information. I'm going to put that down. No, thank you for that, and thank you for being as master of ceremonies. It genuinely means a lot, and I like getting back to the community, so I thought I'd ask you on. I'll be off. Also, thank you to Roger for those words. Nice to know you feel about me after 3 years. It's a shame Emma didn't share that, but you should really like me, but thank you for that. It means a lot. It means the world. I've been speaking to people like Richard, and not be rude, I don't like him, but about this speech, and I've been deliberating over it for weeks and weeks and weeks, and everybody says, groom's got easy speech today, you only have to say your thank yous, and that's it. It's not that simple. I mean, brother absolutely killed this, but I find it difficult to speak in public, especially when I've got to speak publicly about how I appreciate some people in the room who I wouldn't dream of telling them in normal life. Mum, don't laugh, it's you. I've got to say thank you on behalf. This is from me and Emma, so without further ado, on behalf of my wife and I, I'd like to give. We'd like to thank each and every one of you for turning up today and sharing this day with us. I mean, I know some of you are about to make special arrangements for children, sister in law picking up and that, loving it. Time off work for people, because we've been a Sunday because we're tight. And I just want to thank everyone for that. Thank you in advance for the cards and gifts and everything like that. We'll tell you, I think, grateful we are when we see how much money we've got to spend in New York. And whether each and every one of you realises it or not, at some point in our lives, both before we met and since we've been together, you've all played a massive part, which is why we invited you to dinner. Why am I getting emotional? I know this from us as a married couple, but there are a personal thank you that I want to say myself. Firstly, I want to thank Emma's parent.
One's gone. She's gone.
It was my speech that did it.
Is that weird? Killed her off, right?
Didn't want to listen to yours.
You've raised an absolute treasure, your daughter. And how she behaves now is a true testament to how Liz has brought her up. Joking aside, thank you. You've raised a wonderful daughter, and I will make sure I try for the rest of my life to make sure I treat her like you've treated her and bring her.
Hold him to that.
Yeah, better go with that. I would thank Liz, but she disappeared, so I'm not going to. And then I guess moving on to my parents.
What can I say?
Firstly, I want to thank you for being so disappointed in your first child. You felt it necessary to conceive again so you haven't failed at life.
I'm with you.
All joking aside, I think I'll speak on Christian, I think I'll speak on behalf of me and Arcus on this, is that you've always given us everything we've ever wanted in life.
Have you got money?
I know, when we were younger, there were times where money were a problem, people were in that way, we were always struggling, but me and my brother never went behind. Genuinely. And I'm dad stop laughing because this is serious. I want to thank Cavity Walls.
They didn't lose much weight, did they, with Cavity Walls?
Oh, this is returned, so I'll get back to Liz. Oh, thanks. I'll come back to you in a second.
Generous like that.
One other thing I want to say about is, genuinely, you have been a massive influence on my life, both of you. You more so than my dad, mum. And then genuinely, I thank you for about me, for everything you've done for us. I hope you're proud of the man I've become. I hope you're proud of me today for marrying Anna. And I want to thank you for being brilliant grandparents to Isla and basically being a childcare facility in there for all your grandchildren, so thank you. I want to say a personal thank you to you because I know how much work Emma's put in, but also how much work you've put into today. And today wouldn't have been possible without you over the last few months organising things and being very strict and you. But no, I think genuinely, thank you. It means the world. To all my friends. Consider myself genuinely fortunate to have grown up with all my friends who are here today.
Are you sure?
Apart from Diva, sorry. They're genuinely one of the nicest bunch of lads you'll ever meet, and no matter who meets them, they've got nothing but positive things to say about them. And there's times in the last 4, 5, 6 years where I've disappeared for months on end, and even when I've come back into the group, you've been permanently, when you've been to the nothing changes, they're never any different from me, and I can't thank them enough for it. I genuinely can't. I also want to thank them for this thank in Edinburgh. And for them who weren't there, if you keep watching, tell you'll see that I look as solid 10 as they give them.
Surprising
vehicle, isn't it? And if any mate wants to come round at some point,
it's
near looking good to my head. I will like $1 million. I've got cracking nipples as well. Within my group of friends, and I think it's same everyone I have, you've got a smaller group of friends who you're a lot closer, well, not a lot closer to, but you spend a lot more time with them. This group's no different to me. I've got 3 friends in particular. You're coming soon. But I've got Sam, Simi and Richard who have been my ushers today. And again, I can't thank them for enough, because when I've gone for months on end and I've spoke to come out with a reputed part anywhere, nothing changes. Genuinely nothing changes. And they are the best lads I could wish for to be my closest friends. I genuinely mean it as well. I also want to thank my brother-in-law, Matthew, firstly for his reading today, but ever so emotional. And I also want to thank my brother, who, well,
turned up.
Apparently, my brother, but he, both for being ushers today, thank you for being part of it, and I hope you enjoy your waistcoat and bow tie that I paid for. And apart from my bride, there are 3 other women today that I need to thank, and that is the bridesmaids, so Ella, Sarah and Hayley. You all look stunning today, and I'm sure Fitz is going to delve into that a little bit more in his speech, I've no doubt about that. thank you, you all look beautiful today, thank you for, one, getting Emma here and ready on time, and just being there for us throughout our life, thank you. So if everyone can raise their glasses, I'd like to propose a toast to the bridesmaids. To the bridesmaids! I also want to have a quick shout out to Jose and Fern, who's gone, and obviously Isla for being our flower girls today. They look really cute, they look beautiful. And another thank you to bridesmaids for getting that Isla in one piece. Thank you.
There's only two more people to go, and then I'll hand you over to this next person I need to mention. He's been like a brother to me for the last 18 years, I think it is now.
Is that all?
Feels like a lot of time, doesn't it, Paul?
I think I've got 20, Nick.
Is it 20?
20.
You're living in
all. Can you change for his paperwork?
All joking aside, he's genuinely, well, I've got my own brother, but he's been better, and it's... He has literally, throughout... everything I've been through in my life, he's always the first one that I turn to, and he's always been there for me. He's given me good advice sometimes, sometimes not so good advice, but he's always been more than an ear to lend, and I can't thank you enough for it, and what? I don't need to pre-warn you about it. He lives in a bit of a fantasy land. He's a compulsive liar. And I know he's going to spend 10 minutes absolutely ripping me to shreds. He doesn't, none reach me. It's fine. Just please, just pacify him. Laugh, clap along to him. Just make him feel good about himself, please. Thank you. And finally, last but by no means least, to my beautiful bride. The biggest thank you goes to you. I can't even begin to explain to anyone how we've got here. I can't, because I'd like to
I'm still drunk.
Alcohol's a good start. I mean, there's no need for that.
Well, for you
anyway. Oh God, candles are gone. I'd like to stand in front of everyone and say we had a Disney tale love story and fairy tale love story and how spectacular it was from day one, and it actually wasn't. It was far from it. I distinctly remember telling Becky, thank you for doing arena today. I messaged Becky because me and Emma met at work, and I told her that I thought about asking Emma out on a date. I didn't know at this point that Becky relayed that message to my wife, who said she would rather contract a life-threatening illness than sleep with Nick Evers. Oh dear. And married in a child later. I had to get it in the eye. I'm not going to go into details of what you said because it's vile. But now that's out of the way, I think I need to genuinely be serious and sincere to you. And I'd like to start by saying that this, but everyone can see it. You look absolutely stunning today. And that's difficult for me to say because it's a nice thing.
Yeah, that's a compliment.
I can't describe the pride that I felt when I turned around and saw you walking down the aisle. The only thing I could compare it to is Isla being born.
Oh.
I don't really know how I kept it together and come. So it's all there, honestly. You've been by far and away the most incredible and positive thing that's ever happened in my life. There's been times where not a lot of people know in this room that I've been rock bottom. I think it's fair to say. And there's times that I've struggled. You've always been there. You've always been my rock. You've always been my shoulder to cry on the early occasion. You've always been my partner in crime. Literally.
Yeah.
Getting caught stealing from Asda.
No.
I just think that bit. No one needs to know that. You are genuinely mean and forever will be. No disrespect, but my best friend. You really will. You mean the world to me. And without a doubt, our greatest achievement is sat on your mum's knee.
Yeah.
From the minute we found out you're pregnant to the minute we were born to today, you've been... It's been admirable what you've done for someone who didn't strike me as the maternal type, I think it's fair to say.
Yeah.
You took to it like duck to water, and you've been incredible. You're the most amazing role model for Isla, and I can't tell you how proud I am to be your husband. Yeah. Genuinely can't. I've lost my place. I'll finish by saying you have made me the happiest man in the world. I'm marrying you today, and I will love you for the rest of my life. So with that, I'll get that sucker. And I all ask you to mute. raising glasses and to toast to my beautiful bride, Emma.
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 Now, as promised, I will hand you over to my best. I don't need you for this, Rich. I'll introduce him because he's going to tear me apart. I'll hand you over to my best man who should think long and hard about what he's going to say, because if you haven't realised how much you're punching the loser, payback is going to be a bitch.
It's not a checking now. That's an old lady and gentleman.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm already excited.
I'll be honest, Emma and Nick, I didn't think I'd be doing this speech after doing a full dance routine to Jackson 5. So thanks very much. I'd like to start off by making an apology in advance. I should tell you that when me and Nick went to collect today's suits, he pulled me to one side and asked me to refrain from mentioning any past girlfriends in today's speech. Sadly, that's why it's out only 20 seconds in the series. We are for bridesmaids. Let's read you a bit. I'd like to thank Nick for your kind words. I think everybody will agree the bridesmaids look beautiful today and have done a brilliant job, not only today but in the build up as well. So thanks very much. Before I start with a few stories about Nick, Emma, I just want to say that you look absolutely stunning today. Or as we're saying, Kimberworth, you've scrubbed up rain to rain. Nick, I think you've done extremely well. You found someone who's beautiful, clever, funny, loving, caring, and a great mum. And Emma, well, you've got Nick, haven't you?
Yeah.
Anyway, that's enough of me cheesy jokes. Now on to Nicholas Simon Evers. I first met Nick at comprehensive school. We were both young, fresh-faced 11-year-olds and we kicked it off immediately. Nick was confident, chirpy and had a great sense of humour. All times change. Back then, life was a simpler time. Fashion-wise, all you needed to look good were a pair of Adidas poppers and some knock-off rock balls from Ben. I told you, Ian, and you were sorted. However, as we grew older, Nick decided to express himself more and more through the voice of fashion. At this point, I'd like to take this time to appreciate some of Nick's greatest fashion moments in the old mind. Alarm bells first started ringing it when he started wearing more armbands, sorry, more sweatbands on his arm than Pete Sampras at Wimbledon.
He's gone.
Next came Nick's utter and complete obsession with a New York hip-hop group, G-Unit. Where Nick would dress as 50 Cent to any occasion. It was a very embarrassing time for all involved. Then came Nick's Von Dutch cap obsession. Now I don't know which knockoff Nigel you were getting these hats from, Nick. But I know you had one for every single day at week. And I know you weren't earning 125 quid a week, how much those caps cost. Personally, I was never offended by the Von Dutch caps, but when you started wearing that bandana underneath it, that said love, sex, rock and roll on it, that's when you really started raising a few eyebrows around school. We've had some classic... Well, sorry, we've had some great hairstyles throughout the years also, haven't we? Oh, we've had the blonde streaks, a staple in the early days of his friendship. Then we've had the skinhead when we went round to Dave's house and thought it'd be a good idea to shave his head. That's when everyone started realising he looked like Maggot from No Bloody Chain. I've had Simon ring me up, kicking off, saying, listen, you need to come round and sort your mates out. I'm just moving round to call for him, he's got a girl's head band in his head. I know he did. Never forget. And my personal favourite,
with Council Kevin Peterson haircut. When you had a long streak from one side of your head that went all the way around to the other. Absolute classic. I'm delighted to say that in the past few years Nick has passed over old-fashioned duties over to Emma, who has quite frankly done a remarkable job in turning Nick's failing fashion career around. At this point, I'd like to thank Emma for all your hard work. I've got a little gift for you. So thank you very much.
Oh, he's got props?
No, it's not a bundle chat. I don't want to follow them.
Thank you, sweetheart.
No,
thank you.
It's alright.
He's going back tomorrow.
Is it real?
He's filled that with a selection of sweatbands, that.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Now, I don't think many people in the room will know this, but one of Nick's favourite pastimes was ghost hunting.
Well done, Peter.
I can't remember when Nick first told me he was into ghost hunting, and I thought, fair play, mate. He asked me at the time not to tell anyone, and I was like, of course I won't, your secret's safe for me, I'm your best pal. And I thought that was that. If Nick wanted to be at one with the spirits, that was fine with me. At least he's only told me and I won't tell anyone until his wedding day. At that stage, I'm brutally honest, I didn't want anyone finding out I'm best mates with a weirdo. Nick's problem, and in turn my problem, is that I was not the only person he told this secret to. Which he never told me. And before we both knew it, the secret had gotten out that it was Robin's version of Bill Murray and Derek Acora. I didn't know who Derek Acora was, so did I. Because of this, I think it's fair to say, Nick, you've got a lot of necessary stick throughout the years. I know for a fact that one person close to me used to put a sheet over their heads and run up and down the street outside your house pretending to be ghosts. They did tell me later on that they backfire on them though, when they were laughing that hard at themselves, that they actually wet themselves outside your house. Nick, I know you've always enjoyed ghosts, haven't you? And in my opinion, a man should never give up on their dreams. So with that, I've got you a little gift as well, pal.
Life away. Tell
it off from then.
Thanks, Dave.
I've got one upstairs as well, so later on.
Get dressed up later.
I'll go out.
He's been slimed.
Right, now I've been instructed to feed off this piece of paper and it's getting me late and serve early and serve you nice things. Nick, you really are the best mate I could ask for. Throughout the past 18 to 20 years, you've always been there for me when I've had a problem, and I can say that I've honestly spent some of the best days of my life with you. You really are a great human, and it's been an absolute pleasure to watch you grow into the kind, confident, considerate father and husband that you've become today. Emma, I want to thank you for helping Nick become into the great man he's become today. I've known Nick a long time now, and throughout that entire time I've known him, I can say I've never seen him happier than he's in your company. From the moment I saw you both together, I knew you'd end up getting married. I'm delighted to see you both so happy, and Nick, although you've decided to leave me for a girl, I couldn't wish you a more perfect bride than Emma. So, ladies and gentlemen, with that, can I ask you all to stand? Raise a glass and let's go absolutely bananas and have a few drinks tonight for the new Mr. and Mrs. Evers!